The crowds have been coming in thick and fast here for the HSBC BWF World Tour Finals 2023. Fantastic support, I can tell you. And even in an early morning, like we are right now, there are plenty of fans in here. And of course, with lots of Chinese representation, they have so much to cheer about. And they'll have plenty to cheer now, because coming up, we've got women's doubles. Yu Shengshu and Tan Ning are playing Apriani Rahayu and Siti Fania Silva Ramadhanti of Indonesia. This is how things stand in Group A. And it is a straight shootout for Yu Shengshu and Tan Ning against Apriani Rahayu and Siti Ramadhanti. That's mainly because of what's happened with Mayu Matsumoto and Wakana Nagahara. That is a walkover, that match between them and Chen and Jia, outside after an injury yesterday, suffered by the Japanese. And that means that whoever wins this match coming up is going through to the semi-finals. That's the very simple equation you have here between Yu Shengshu and Tan Ning against Apriani Rahayu and Siti Fania Silva Ramadhanti. Now this crowd's going to get nicely warmed up. I'll be looking to play spoiler here today. So they've only met once before, the Chinese player winning that French Open recently in three games. Meet our players then, starting with the Yu Shengshu. Who is just 19 years of age from the North, Liaoning. Only playing at a best ranking of 975 centimeters tall. Former girls doubles champion. Last year, the World Junior Championships. And here is Tan Ning. Just 20 years of age, from the south in Fujian. Still very new pairing overall. Just 170 centimeters tall. They've already won four titles together in their brief time. All, of course, this year. We'll go into that detail in just a short while. Excellent work from them. And, of course, unfortunately, that match yesterday, Matsumoto Nagahara to retire, and they lost pretty convincingly to Chen and Jia Yifan. That match, those points don't count now. Apriani Rahayu here, of course, the best known of all these players. 25 years of age. Feels like she's been around forever. centimeters tall. Currently have seventh in the world. She was as high as three. That was with Grecia Poli, achieved in 2018. Of course, they went on to win the gold medal at the Olympic Games in Tokyo. World Championships as well. They got third twice in 2018 and 2019. Though this year, with a new partner, 2023, they were silver medalists. And here is Siti Ramadhanti, who's 23. Very young, all of these players here at the moment. From Bogor. Got a gold at the Southeast Asian Games in 2021, Vietnam. And together, they have won three titles together. Lost to Chung and Chia very convincingly. Beat Matsumoto Nagahara. Again, that result isn't going to count. Same as their opponents today. That's why this is a straight shootout. Rahana Da Silva of Sri Lanka is our umpire. Company. He has got Trish Gubb of New Zealand. She is our service judge.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Siti Padia Silva Ramadhanti and Apriani Rahayu, Indonesia. And on my left, Randy and Liu Jing Chu, China.
Here we go.
Siti Padia Silva Ramadhanti to serve to Liu Jing Chu, low ball. Play.
Just a sign of things to come. Oh dear. Is that what we're in for now? Well, the Indonesians have one title to the name this year, the Hong Kong Open. They lost in the final of the Hilo Open, that's a 300. They got to the semis of the Malaysia Open, that's a 1,000. The French Open, a Super 750. And the Swiss Open, a Super 300. They've only got together very recently. French Open, 750. The Arctic Open, a 500. And two 300s, the Spain Masters and the US Open. They lost in the final of the Australian Open and Japan Masters. That was recently. Kumamoto won. They're both 500s. And they lost in the Orleo Masters. That's a 300. And they got to the semis of the Hilo Open. That's a Super 300. Very good year for them.
Seven,
it's just their debut season, remember. They show that the ability, they can take on the very best. No less than 7 finals in your debut year. So young as well. Lots to look forward to. Winner there from Ramadhanti.
2-0.
Just telling herself about controlling it. You can see. Even start to this one. But only bright couple of points for Liu and Tan. Aggressive view.
4-3.
Well, the Indonesians once returned in the won their first title in over years, I said, the Hong Kong Open. Followed that up with a final at the Hilo Open, so they kind of started the year fairly okay, and then ended it pretty decently. Nice touch on there from Tan Ning.
5-4.
A little low there for Apriani Rahayu. Groan, an audible groan when A point doesn't go Chinese way. Tando still in front. Here's Luna on serve. Ramadhanti under a little bit of pressure here. Stop drop being played by Thandik. Good intervention there. That's a bit of deception as well. He's now up to three. Look quite good here for the Chinese. They can build on this. No! Now four, quicker points.
9-5. Correction,
there of Apriani Rahayu. Passive, just a bit like what we saw from Darugul and Bajokjai. Lead by five here, Liu Tan. Nicely new. This has been a very good start here for the Chinese pair. Already a 6-point lead. Seems quite happy on this end. 11-5 in game one.
Cari stop, cari serangan. Nah, serangannya jangan terlalu ke arah ini. Ya, ternyata pojokin aja sini. Kalau silang tuh agak jauh, nggak enak. Kalau di sini ke bank tuh lebih sulit. Ya, ada yang macam-macam. Jadi arahnya ke pojok ke sini. Kalau serangnya ke pojok ke sini. Jadi kalau buang silang pun nggak terlalu. Ya, coba terus. Ya, ya. Pas depan belakangnya di hati. Sabarin.
There were a couple of times in this rally already the Chinese could have perhaps killed us off. was a bit stretched. Good play. That was Rahayu's spot there to stretch Liu. This one. It's good teamwork from the Indonesians.
Thank you.
51 shots.
Not like quite the opening rally we had.
Picked a spot. Went right across Ramadhanti. Achieved so much in badminton with Grisha Poli, but they only ever got to the semi-finals back in 2021. Otherwise, it's been group stage exits over time in three previous season finals. Under some pressure here. He's up to seven now.
Seven.
Yeah, these two were eliminated in the group stages last time out as well. Ramadhanti and Rahayu. Just so impressive. Done so well. They have had a few early exits, the Malaysia Masters, Japan Open, and Denmark Open, as well as Hong Kong Open. It's well out. Lead they've enjoyed 8 points to Liu and Tan. Dominated the World Tour Finals since it was introduced in 2018. Got 9 titles across 5 seasons. I've had it. Only nation to have produced winners in all 5 categories in men's doubles, of course, the favourites to do so. That was a jump smash there from Apriani Rahayu. Seen too many of those from her. Japan can join their club, by the way, if that's now been Higashino win here. Big ask. Couple of nine points here for the Indonesians. Going out, tough call had to be made by Thundering. Three in a row. Much better from the Indonesians, their best run so far. Just trying to urge him on to wrap up this first game. Real promise for China in this department. New pair coming through. Chen Ching Chen Jai finally really ruling the roost. Chinese are in those sort of areas, it is tough for the Indonesians. The lifts are just not having the right kind of effect at the moment. All in the zone for the Chinese to put away. And this has certainly run away from the Indonesians in game one. We have to start thinking of the second game now, where this is going. Plenty of game points for Lu and Tan. Hey.
Service over 11-20.
Still one saved. And another.
12-20.
Well, this is a decent run from the Indonesians, but it's come far too late. Late flurry of points here. Is wrapped up very, very comfortably for Lu and Tan. Fantastic start from them. It all started to go a little wrong for the Indonesians from 4-all onwards. The Chinese pair surging very quickly, helped by a 2-5 point runs.
Tapi jangan tempatnya main break terus, tapi kadang-kadang ada ngapain masuk-masuk aja nggak apa-apa. Apa dia mundur langsung cepet cari serangan. Gitu. Ya tuh jangan kepancing panjang terus, dia nggak lari. Justru
kalau dia... Apri ambil depan dulu aja ya?
Apri depan dulu
ya kan? Depan dulu.
Jadi main depan.
Kalau di belakang dia panjang-panjang gitu ya?
Nah kalau kamu ketemu clear nggak enak, kamu clear dulu nggak apa-apa. Nanti habis itu dari defense, ini
baru masuk.
Gitu. Nah kalau enak, baru nggak apa-apa kamu
turunin. Main benternya gitu ya?
Variasi gitu ya. Apa dia juga sama nggak apa-apa depan lagi depan dulu aja jangan tim cuma pengen ini apri jadi fokusnya lagi di depan kamu dulu gitu aja situasinya lebih yakin lagi serangannya tinggal arah-arahin nah apri tinggal fokus depannya sudah nggak usah mikir ke belakangnya kalau nggak enak baru clear tinggi biar
lo sih lihat di sa di sa lo lo sih jadi sa sih sa bersih kau mainin lagi lo itu cikgu juga mau lo bahu lo sa wajib sih lo bahu lo bahu lo bahu lo bahu 脚不要停球门落地不要停他们很难杀死不要吧不要着急丢两分没关系把接发球接小拉的发球不要输接把他的发球接就问题不大只要自己不要乱自己不要乱我打力了你老是想去你看人家小球接不住我打力了你老是想去你看人家小球接不住
Second game here. Let's see if the Indonesians prefer being on this end. That helped them. Certain Chinese were enjoying it. Nominally the faster end, I have to say. But once Rahayu gets into those jump smashes, which really get into in the first. We saw a good fight back. It was a similar type of story, wasn't it? In the previous doubles match.
women's doubles. Certainly playing much better in the second game. It was the other end, in fact. So three unanswered points for Rahayu and Ramadhanti here. Chinese pair this year of 63 matches.
Oh! And
147 of them. First year together, first full season. Hugely impressive. Lovely. So perhaps that win rate in the opening season is impressive. For the Indonesians, they've won 40 out of 58. It's about 69%. Too bad. They got together last year. First challenge today, if I'm not mistaken. Challenge from the Chinese pair, it is very much out. Skims the net. Shots that they were making with ease in the first game. A little bit of Indonesian support somewhere in the crowd. Well, there's Indonesians everywhere you go, generally, in the circuit. And there. Always capable of making a bit of noise in any arena. Never going to miss.
Yes, that was you. Rahayu.
14-19.
Looking better for the Indonesians. Long on that one. Was there for the taking. Just to the delight of the Chinese players, Indonesians looked a little surprised by that. Necessary. From Tan Ning. Looked like the smash was on. Opted not for it. The deception didn't work. Good. Now, this is pretty early in the second game. They could well be losing all their challenges now if they get this wrong. I thought that was it. Cool. Very nicely done.
7-1. Play.
Standing, beautifully executed. She got there, but just not quite enough on it. Ramadhanti. This one seems a lot more attritional in the second game, a little bit like the last game as well.
8-7.
Play. 16-20. Black. Great placement. 9-7. Well, this is the first time the Chinese have taken the lead in this second game.
Hey.
streaks, but managed to weather the storm perhaps. Saw that happen in the previous match, Kevin Kong. Kong ran off and still managed to win the rally, actually got the winner. And Tia as well, the Chinese have done it. This is a decent lead now that they've got 3 points. 48 shots that rally. Now, another challenge from the Chinese. They got the last one right, but again, if they get this wrong, they've done the challenges for the second game, midway through. That's another great call. Fantastic from Tan. Brilliant, and it means the Chinese are 11-7 up here in game two, having already taken the first one. It's going to be a problem for the Indonesians. And I've got to say, those two calls from Tan, really good ones, that have contributed to this 5-point lead now. This is really running away from the Indonesians. Starting to look like the previous game, especially when, which is frustrating because they were in front all the way until it got to Sahul. There's another flash in the crowd. Everyone's trying to film the Chinese pairs walking in on the other court.
Well,
we're getting plenty of announcements in the crowd. Yeah, it's all going really well at the moment. They're on the front foot, they're attacking. The Indonesians are finding it really difficult to get themselves out of a jam here. I've played too many Indonesians in their brief time together. Dunning and Shinshu, they won all four of them prior to today. We look back at the play, and that's the right shot to play where Ramadhanti's not going to be able to recover in time. A lot closer than we'd think. Ninth versus seventh, the Chinese rank slightly below the Indonesians, and met recently, about a month and a half ago, at the French Open.
57.
They won that one in three. It took about an hour and a half almost. Looks highly unlikely at this stage, you have to say. Reminder, this is a straight shootout. The winner goes through to the semi-finals behind Chen Tian Jiayu Fan. Had a long rally in quite some time. Took the pace right off it. Points, isn't it? It's difficult. They had a great run of 9 points earlier. Shinshu and Tan Ning just came to an end, but they've basically won 10 of the last 11 points. That's tough. That stage they were 6-7 down. That's what's taking it away from the Indonesians. It's all becoming a little easy now for the Chinese. Out. It's almost over here. Looks like another group stage exit looming. Now, what a remarkable year this is turning out to be for Liu and Tan. Whopping 12 match points awaits now. Match point 2023 has been excellent for Liu and Tan. And they will end it with a semi-final place at the very least in the HSBC BWF World Tour Finals. Well, that's nice to see. I'm afraid another group stage exit for this Indonesian pair. And Apriani Rahayu has only once ever got through to the knockout stages since 2018, when she first appeared at the semis. But for now, it's all about the Chinese pair who hit a shuttle into the crowd. Fantastic. They were very good, weren't they, throughout. And that is an extremely easy shootout. Remember, both pairs looking for a place in the semi-finals. And they won it very, very comfortably, Liu and Tan. And they maintain their perfect record against Indonesian pairs in a very brief career as well, to be fair. It's 5 out of 5 now. Crowd enjoying this. We'll see more Chinese representation in the final four. Liu Shengxu and Tan Ning of China beat Apriani Rahayu and Siti Fadia Silva Ramadhanti of Indonesia. 21-13, 21-8. It's happened in 51 minutes. Next up, it is men's doubles. Japan against China. Hoki and Kobayashi take on Liu and Tan.